Hello, BookTube. I've got one more bookish event announcement for you. This is March Mystery Madness, which you may remember from last year. I was one of the co-hosts of March Mystery Madness. Elizabeth at Lizzie Fay Books has been hosting this for 5 years. This is a five-year-old event. It's amazing. We're starting to see this with things like Nonfiction November or March Mystery Madness. We're starting to see BookTube events that are reaching a venerable age. And this is round five of March Mystery Madness, where in the month of March we read and love and discuss mysteries of all kinds, all variations. And I'm not hosting this year, but I am still the March Mystery Madness's biggest fan. So there's all sorts of stuff. There's a Goodreads group, there's a hashtag, there are all sorts of reading challenges, most of them grouped around the concept of five, of the number five, in lots of interesting ways. And Sarah at Steeped in Books, she's one of the co-hosts this year along, and she transformed the prompts into a bingo card. Because there's something wrong with her. Her bingo card is tremendous. And all of the videos that I've watched are just a delight. People going at this from all kinds of different angles. And I want to do that too. I think what I will do is Mystery Monday. So we'll do four mystery updates in the course of the month. Or maybe five. Don't I remember there being five weekends in March? There five weekends in March? What if there were, that would be wonderful, because that would go with the fifth, with the five prompt. But let's just say we'll meet five times for March Mystery Madness in the course of March and talk about all things mystery. I'm going to kick off. I've been on a mystery binge in 2020, as some of you know, if you've been watching this channel. I have been for some unknown reason, I have been absolutely fascinated with mysteries. I've been reading a ton of just a ton of them. But most of the mysteries that I've been reading have been old. Judge Dee mysteries, Dorothy Sayers mysteries, Georgette Heyer mysteries, now Catherine Aird. Found a bunch of Catherine Aird. I've been reading those British village mysteries from the Golden Age, between the wars. And that started to make me wary that I'm already narrowing the field too much. So I'm paying attention to the mysteries that I get in the mail, and that I have got in the mail and maybe haven't paid enough attention to. Just the other day, I noticed that I still had unread the Best American Mystery Stories of 2019. This is the Best American series. You know, they do Best American Short Stories, Best American Travel Writing, and all that. And this is the mystery stories. And most of what I've been reading has not been American mystery stories. I don't know how these are going to strike me. I get the impression, maybe it's incorrect, maybe it's unfair, about American mysteries, that their plots are less well done, sloppier. But I could be wrong about that, and I certainly could be wrong about the things that are in this book. I also have, in 2020, been developing an idea that maybe I don't like mystery short stories. That maybe I like a mystery to unfold in the course of a novel, where you can ruminate on things, and characters can compare notes, and red herrings can be flushed out, and wrong pathways can be taken and then corrected. None of that can really happen in the same way with the same generosity in a short story. So, and as a result, most of the short stories that I've read, mystery short stories that I've read in 2020, even in the midst of this mystery binge of mine, this mystery mania, have not pleased me. So I don't know, maybe that will happen here. Maybe these won't please me, both because they're American and because they're short stories. But it kills me that I haven't read this. And now I'm in the perfect mood to do it. And I just got this thing in the mail just a little bit ago. This is, I think, a February release. This is December 31st, 2019. So this is not even, this would ordinarily not be on my reading docket at all. These are two 2019 things that I'm going back to read. This is by Elizabeth Penny, and it is Hems and Homicide, the Apron Shop series. And it's a cozy mystery, obviously. It has a cat on the cover. That I have just not paid any attention to. I want to read mysteries in all of their forms for March Mystery Madness, and that includes cozies. Cozy mysteries are where you're, you know, it's a small environment, it's a closeted environment, it's lots of warm and fuzzy personalities. Usually there are cats involved, and it's almost like the murder in a cozy mystery is an inconvenience. It's just the thing that gets things going. So usually what I have noticed is that in a cozy mystery, the person who gets killed will be unlikable. In other words, the death won't be anything that causes anyone any grief. Instead, it will solely be the kernel of a mystery. So let's see. This is the first in the Apron Shop Mystery Series, set in the quaint village of Blueberry Cove, Maine. See, so it's a quaint village. They are a dime a dozen when it comes to cozy mysteries. Iris Buckley is so ready for a change. S-E-W. After the death of her beloved grandfather, Iris decides to stay in her Maine hometown to help out her widowed grandmother, Anne, and bring her online handmade apron designs to real-time retail life. So she has some sort of Etsy shop, and now she's going to be able to put them in a store. Her and Anne's shop, Ruffles and Bows, is set to include all the latest vintage linen fashions, a studio for sewing groups and classes, and a friendly orange cat. The only thing that they were not planning to have on the property? A skeleton in the basement. Anne recognizes the remains of an old friend, and when a second body shows up in the apron shop, this time their corrupt landlord, whom Anne had been feuding with for decades. See, it's always a heel or horrible person who ends up dead in the cozy mysteries. She becomes a prime suspect. Now it's up to Iris to help clear her name. Enlisting the help of her old high school crush, Ian Stewart, who, like certain fabrics, has only gotten better looking with age, Iris must piece together an investigation to find out who the real killer is and find a way to stop her brand new business from being scrapped in the process. I read some of these cozy mysteries, the ones with puns in the title. I read some of them, they always bring a smile to my face. Like the Clam Shack murder mystery featuring the giant lobster named Lobzilla, or Wonton Terror, that there's a Chinese food sort of restaurant themed cozy mysteries. There are a few ongoing series of cozy mysteries, and I read them as I get them. And they don't do much for me. They're clever. There's a smile on my face the whole time, but they're again rather sloppy in terms of the likelihood, the plausibility, the machinery of their actual murder plot. And I don't know if that's that I'm being too critical, or I'm just being unfair, because the golden age of murder mysteries was just much better at that sort of thing than any contemporary author would be. And that seems to me a little condescending. So these will be two of the mystery fair that I will be starting out with for March Mystery Madness. But I'm going to be reading lots of murder mysteries in March. Because we have an event, a venerable BookTube event, 5 years of March Mystery Madness, I will be taking you through all of that murder mystery reading, and we'll see what we make of it all. But I'm not hosting, so I won't be doing any of the prompts except accidentally. But I'll leave all the information down below, because you should follow this. If you're into mysteries, you're going to love it, because you're in the perfect place. You're surrounded by other mystery addicts. I am very much one of those, so it's great to see March Mystery Madness back. This video was meant, you know, maybe mainly to echo the announcement videos that are being done by the actual hosts, and also to gear you up for all the mystery stuff we're going to be doing in March. So I'm going to wrap this up for now. But I'll be back. Thank you, BookTube.